You can't credibly claim to be a patriot while trying to overturn an election with no evidence. But we have been living through the most sustained attack on an election result since the Civil War. Democracy itself is under assault, and that's the subject of a major speech about voting rights from President Biden later today. But it's been tough for some folks to see the truth because the big lie keeps getting repeated. And that's why I want to recap the results of all the hunts to find actual voter fraud to date. Think of it as a definitive guide to debunking the big lie. First, remember that Trump's legal team lost nearly 60 cases in court, many at the hands of Trump-appointed judges. That's a blowout, folks. And in the 6 months since the Capitol attack, there have been extensive efforts by Republicans in at least 8 states to back up Trump's baseless claims. And they have come up with nothing. Nada. Ningún. Take Michigan, where GOP state senators convened a special committee, and after 28 hours of hearings, they found that the only real fraud had been the claims of mass voter fraud. In fact, they recommended that the Democratic AG investigate those folks who've been pushing the election lies. In neighboring Wisconsin, when the Trump campaign demanded a recount, it resulted in a gain of 87 votes for Joe Biden. And when election officials dug into the results deeper, they found 13 possible cases of voter fraud out of nearly 3.3 million votes cast. In New Hampshire, auditors found no evidence of widespread fraud, despite Trump's hype. Same thing happened in Nevada after an investigation by the Republican Secretary of State. In Georgia, Republican Secretary of State Brad Raffensperger was censured after he resisted Trump's request to find 11,000 votes. But 2 recounts and an audit confirmed those election results. In Texas, indicted Republican AG Ken Paxton had a special team spend 22,000 hours searching for voter fraud. And after all that time and taxpayer money, they found 16 minor cases out of 11 million ballots cast. And that $1 million reward from Texas Lieutenant Governor Dan Patrick, which he offered for evidence of voter fraud, still hadn't been paid out, despite Pennsylvania's Lieutenant Governor pushing for payment in exchange for his state's 3 documented cases of voter fraud, which were all from Republicans. That hadn't stopped some Keystone State Republicans from trying to keep the false claims alive, even after those audits showed that results were accurate. They're one of 5 states trying to follow the Arizona fraudit, which has been denounced by local Republicans as a grift disguised as an audit, political theater, and insane lies. It's even more absurd because the audits were already done in Arizona and found no fraud. So take a step back. Look at the results of these audits and recounts and Republican-led investigations in 8 states, and you'll see there's just no actual evidence of mass voter fraud. There's only the desperate attempt to keep doubt alive, to please Donald Trump at the expense of our democracy. And if you're still not sold, remember how fast Fox News and Newsmax backtracked when threatened with a lawsuit from Dominion Voting Systems. Listen to Trump's loyal AG Bill Barr, who finally resigned because he thought Trump's claims were, quote, bullshit. Or look at the newly unearthed email from the RNC's top lawyer describing Trump's legal team as a joke that was getting them, quote, laughed out of court because they are misleading millions of people who have wishful thinking. If you believe their claims, then I'm sorry to say the joke's on you. But of course, the real insult is to our democracy. And that's a cause that all real patriots should rush to defend. And that's your reality check.
And John, let me just, you know, we've had a number of authors on today with books about this time period. Michael Wolff wrote that the Friday after Election Day, there was not a single White House aide or Trump campaign official or Trump pollster who believed that the vote count could reasonably or effectively be challenged.
That's right.
They knew it was BS
all along. So all the Trump supporters who've still been duped need to face the fact that they've been lied to by the Trump administration.